Hello everyone, I'm Anup Marotta. The topic of my paper is LoRa Mesh Network for Smart Metering in Rural Electrification. Other authors of this paper are Yuraj Bhandari, Ashish Shrestha, Ajay Singh, Anup Thapa, and Shikoju Sen. These are the contents of my presentation. First, I'll start with the introduction, then I'll discuss the problem description, then idea generation, then methodology, then I'll discuss the proposed solution, and the resultant discussion, then finally I'll discuss the conclusion. Smart meters are devices capable of remote monitoring of energy consumption by electricity users. Smart meters are required to have bidirectional communication capabilities. The bidirectional communication capabilities of smart meters enables the concept of smart grid and peer-to-peer energy trading. So smart meters are very important part of a smart power system. However, there are many challenges related to the implementation of smart metering system. The main challenge for smart metering is communication system. Commonly practiced methods for communication in smart metering are cellular networks, ISP-based internet, and other RF-based technologies. So, these commonly practiced techniques cannot be universally applied, especially in rural areas due to unavailability of their infrastructures. These systems also have high operating and deployment cost. The other RF-based technologies like Bluetooth, XB, ZigBee, despite of their high data rate capabilities, are not applicable due to short range. So there is a need of a system that is cheap to deploy, has long operating range, and has sufficient communication range. Currently, LoRaWAN operates on star topology, in which every node needs to be connected to the gateway for communication, which leads in the requirement of multiple number of gateways. The deployment cost of gateway is very high compared to a smart meter. The gateway requires internet to operate, but internet may not be available in the required locations. Due to these issues, there is a need of communication architecture which requires minimum number of gateways to operate. For the convenient solution generation, methodology as shown in diagram was followed. Existing technologies in practice were reviewed, then problems associated with the current technologies were identified. Potential solutions for these problems were analyzed and a suitable solution was developed. Then the feasibility of potential solution was analyzed and verified by simulation. Different existing RF technologies were analyzed based on their data rate and available range. Technologies like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, XP, ZigBee has high data rate but not enough range for smart metering. But LoRa has sufficient range and data rate high enough for smart metering purposes. So LoRa was chosen to develop a smart mesh network for smart metering purposes. Figure 3 shows the proposed solution where each smart meter will have a LoRa transceiver and is able to connect to other meters in range and form a mesh network. This network will be used to communicate with cloud. Figure 4 shows the algorithm to be followed by the gateway to invite and register new users to the network. And figure 5 shows the query function that is used to extract data from a specific node by the gateway. The data extracted by the gateway is sent to the cloud. If operator needs to send any command to the node, the command is sent to the gateway, and the gateway in turn sends the command to the node. Figure 6 shows the algorithm to be followed by smart meters nodes to get registered to the network. Figure 7 is the sub-function of the main algorithm used to determine the type of data packet and how to respond to the specific data packet. The function of the nodes are relay the information from and to the neighboring nodes, help nodes get registered to the network. These are algorithms to be followed by smart meters. Now in the result and discussion part, figure 8 shows how the end-to-end delay of the communication varies with the increasing number of nodes to the network. Figure 9 shows how the variation of packet delivery rate happens with increasing number of nodes, and figure 10 shows the variation of packet delivery rate with increasing packet size. Simulation was done for the spreading factor of 7. That is the spreading factor to which we can get the highest data rate in LoRa. An average meter generates a traffic of about 3 kilobytes per day and receives 200 bytes per day. For a network of 250 nodes, the PDR is calculated to be 70, as we can see in the figure 9. If data is taken at interval of 5 seconds with 100 bits packet size, so 151.2 kilobytes data can be sent by node in a single day if data is collected at 5 second intervals. According to a study, an average meter can generate 3 kilobytes of data per day. So it seems that LoRa mesh can satisfy the requirements of smart metering. Study: a way to use LoRa devices for smart metering has been discussed. This paper proposes a mesh network of LoRa devices to be implemented for smart metering. This study suggests implementation of the proposed algorithm in smart metering hardware to function as a mesh network of smart meters. From the simulation of test network in NS2 network simulator, it is found that LoRaWAN in mesh configuration can achieve required specifications to be implemented for smart metering. Thank you.